Hello everyone, Fernando Gomez-Peralta is here, head of the Endocrinology and Nutrition Unit from the General Hospital of Segovia, Spain. I'd like to summarize our article profile of semaglutide in the management of type 2 diabetes, design, development and placing therapy as published in the journal Drug Design, Development and Therapy. Type 2 diabetes has become one of the leading causes of morbidity and mortality in developed countries. Low efficacy, weight gain, and hypoglycemia are the main pitfalls of previous treatments of type 2 diabetes. New therapies have been designed with the aim of improving the results in efficacy and quality of life. Glucagon-like peptide 1 receptor agonists increase insulin secretion and reduce postprandial glucagon in a glucose-dependent way, and reduce body weight, mainly slowing gastric emptying and increasing central satiety. The last GLP-1 receptor agonist approved by the US Food and Drug Administration and European Medicines Agency has been semaglutide. This article begins explaining the differences in the structure of semaglutide after liraglutide. It maintains a 94% homology with human GLP-1. These changes confer a half-life of approximately 7 days. Clinical efficacy and safety are covered reviewing the global program of clinical trials SUSTAIN, including the phase 3A studies SUSTAIN 1 to 5, the phase 3B SUSTAIN 7 trial comparing semaglutide with the natural comparator dulaglutide, both long-acting GLP-1 receptor agonists administered once weekly, and the cardiovascular safety study SUSTAIN 6. Main characteristics of these randomized control trials are summarized in Table 1. The figures 2 to 4 summarize the main results of those trials with the 0.5 milligrams and 1 milligram dose of semaglutide. Regarding safety issues, as described with other GLP-1 receptor agonists, the more frequent adverse events are gastrointestinal and an increase in pulse rate. Only in the SUSTAIN 6 study, the risk of retinopathy complications were significantly higher versus placebo. A previous ophthalmological exam and specific follow-up are advisable when semaglutide is initiated in insulin-treated patients with a history of diabetic retinopathy or previous poor control. Possibly the most interesting messages of the manuscript for clinicians are depicted in Table 2. Practical considerations on possible clinical scenarios where semaglutide could be an interesting option in the treatment of type 2 diabetes and recommendations on adjustment of concomitant therapy, safety cautions, and efficacy expectancy are depicted. Finally, our disclosures are included in the article. However, we would underline that this commissioned paper from the journal, and we would underline that this is a commissioned paper from the journal and no funding, sponsorship or writing assistance was received for publication of this article, and there was not any intervention from the producing company of semaglutide.